Now we are going to hear the talk by Mr. V. Ramasubramanian. He is a highly qualified person and he is a certified life coach, and also he is a certified trainer by National Federation of Neuro-Linguistic Psychology. And he has got a lot of leadership skills and he has done MBA in human resource, etc. And now he has come forward to give his views on life as it is. And he has talked about Karmendriya and Jnanendriya, etc., which are different from what the other people spoke. And I thank Mr. Ramasubramanian and I welcome him.
Good evening, friends. This is with regard to life as it is. Life as it is for me is continuous learning and sharing. It gives a lot of happiness to me. Then the question comes, whether our experiences are under our control or can we control our experiences. Then we need to understand what influence our experiences. According to me, the environment which we take through our indriyas, jnanendriyas, and our beliefs and values, which I call it as conditioning or programming, these two put together determined our experience. In computer parlance, we can say that output, which is nothing but our experience, is equal to input plus programming, right? The input is our environment which we take it through our indriyas, and programming is our beliefs and values and conditioning. This programming is nothing but how we used our indriyas from our birth. Why from birth? Maybe from earlier birth, I don't know, till the last moment. So if we can control the input and the program, we can definitely control our experience. So in other ways, we can say that our experience is the function of free will and destiny. What is free will? The environment which we take it in through our indriyas is free will, and how we have used our indriyas right from the date of our birth till last moment is the program. So how do we take the inputs using our indriyas? Whenever we see anything, whenever we hear anything, constantly, whether we know or we don't know, it gets into our system. That is the environment we take it in through these indriyas. So we need to be very, very careful. We can use our awareness, we can use our free will to decide which input I am going to give it to myself. Okay. As regards the programming is concerned, I'll give you an analogy how we can overpower the programming. When we were studying in the school, we used to use that ink bottle. So once the ink is over, we used to use the bottle for storing some oil or something, right? So what we do is, we clean the bottle with clean water. The clean water is similar to the input, and the ink color is similar to the programming. So we want to overpower the program. How do we do that? We keep on pouring good water, once, twice, three, four times, till the ink color goes out. So how many times we have to pour clean water? It depends upon the density of the ink. So depending upon the density of the programming, you need to keep continuously using your indriyas for positive functional thing. What is positive and functional? It is for you to decide based on your experiences. So long as your experience is not up to your liking, you are not having the happy experience, or you are not having a feel-good factor experience, then till then you need to understand that I need to overpower my program by continuously using my indriyas. So we have the free will to use our indriyas. Even we see a picture for a minute, or a TV serial, or you see a watching a movie or a YouTube, then that definitely influences as a input as well also as a program for the future transactions. So you need to be very clear. So using the being born as a human being, we have the free will. We have the free will to use the indriyas. The jnana indriyas, with the help of the karma indriyas, we need to use them judiciously. How do we do that? We need vairagya for this. We need viveka for this. What is viveka? You have to differentiate what is good and what is not good, or what is functional and what is not functional for it. What is vairagya? It is also, you can call it as a sankalpa. Once you know what is good for you, you will vow doing only that. And what is not good for you, you will take a vow that you will not do that. You will not use your indriya for that. And third is abhyasa. Abhyasa means continuously you have to practice it. So Patanjali says that abhyasa vairagya abhyam tan nirodaha. We can achieve that. So friends, I wish you all the best. In case you have any questions, feel free to call me 9840340719. Thank you for the opportunity.